Hey guys, it's Mikey. I'm gonna show you my favorite submission. My first submission I'm gonna show you is a straight footlock. I use this position in Black Belt Worlds Finals to finish my opponent in 12 seconds. It's a really strong position. And I'm gonna show you how I do it. So what I do is I make my arm over his foot like so, right? But what I'm doing is, instead of holding my hand like this with this, I grab my elbow so my fulcrum becomes higher on my arm like so. Now when I do the foot lock, I put pressure. I throw my leg over his shin and I start putting pressure here to get the tap, okay? That's my first submission, the street foot. Next position I'm gonna show you is the Mikey lock. I came up with this position and look how I do this one. So what I do is I'll be in any leg configuration like so, and many people use their armpit to do a heel hook. What I'm doing is I use my neck pit to do the same thing, okay? So I make a grip on his leg like so. I place his foot on my head like so. I lock a figure four like so, and I bridge into his knee, applying pressure for the heel hook like so. Now, there's two positions here. This is one on the knee. The second, he starts turning his toe this way, point like this, while I have the submission. Now what's gonna happen is, I start getting pressure on his foot as well, because as his foot starts exceeding his shin, it'll start putting pressure here. As he defends putting pressure with his toes toward his shin, it puts pressure on his knee. You see, so it's a double whammy, like a two submission position. My next position I'm gonna show you guys is from the back. I really like in no-gi doing back triangles. So I'll be here, I'll get a kimura grip, I'll step on his shoulder, I'll put my knee on his shoulder like so, throw my leg over, and I'll lock a side back triangle like so. Either this way, or I'll bring him this direction and lock the triangle this direction. Now I have a double submission threat, which is always good. On his arm, I can put pressure here, or I could apply pressure getting to his leg and squeezing to get the choke here. One more position I'll show you guys is an inside heel hook. This position I really love also, but I prefer when I'm doing an inside heel hook, instead of to do the heel hook like this, I prefer the reverse figure four. The reason being is, when I have the reverse figure four, I can break his knee, or I can break his heel like so and start putting pressure, and I can break his shin right here.
My legs are never gonna be the same.